Hello, Scorpio. Welcome to Rogo's High. This is going to be your love reading for the next 24 to 48 hours. All right, I'm going to go ahead and jump right into it. Please take what resonates. These messages are general, so they may not apply to you. Simple as that. All right, let's go ahead and jump right into it, Scorpio. Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs. Let's see who you're dealing with. Who is Scorpio dealing with in regards to love within the next 24 to 48 hours? Who is Scorpio dealing with? What are their traits? What's your name? What's your sign? Hit us. Who y'all like, Scorpio? Who y'all like to be with? Oh, wow. We got three. Okay, so we have the Six of Cups, the Ace of Cups, and the Nine of Pentacles here. You like yourself. You like yourself a lot. Oh, I love this. But no, I feel like you guys could be dealing with a water sign or earth sign. So Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, Scorpio, Cancer, Pisces. But I feel that there's definitely someone that wants to offer you love. This is someone with the Six of Cups here that hasn't... I don't want to say, but I'm hearing like they haven't had the best of luck in relationships, okay? So they could kind of have this mentality with the Nine of Pentacles, strong emphasis on Taurus. They have this mentality of appearing to be alone. It's almost like to save face, all right? So while they may be offering their cup of love to someone, they could still kind of like look like they're single and shit like that, okay? So I feel like that could be someone that you've dealt with in the past that could have been a trait of theirs that you noticed in the past, okay? Or this is just someone new coming through or someone that you know. But it's definitely someone wanting to offer their love. They're not wanting to be, I'm hearing that I don't want to be a player no more. They don't want to be single anymore. I do feel like this person is very stable within their emotions, their finances, and their mental, and that shit is important. A motherfucker can have all the money in the world, all the peace swinging in the world, the tightest pussy in the world, but if their mind ain't right, it's I ain't had my dome straight. If your mind ain't right, that shit don't matter. Like, I mean, not to me or anybody else in their right mind, I would say. But anywho, this person is very balanced on so many different levels, and I think that they've been watching you. This is someone that's possibly seeing you elevate on a few levels here. Could be someone that you've known over a course of 6 years, alrighty, but I feel that this is someone that really does want to offer you some type of commitment. This person not playing around here. Alright, so let's see where you'll meet this person or where this conversation will have or take place. For Scorpio, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs. When will you be talking to this person? Where? Okay, we have the Seven of Pentacles. All right, Seven of Pentacles. So I'm getting like a kind of work energy is what I'm picking up here. It's just someone that, again, has been watching you grow in some way, shape, or form. It's like they could have been helping you, stimulating your growth, planting seeds with you. So whether that is on an intimate level, maybe you guys share a child together, or you guys just have shared things in the past, okay? Information, wisdom. You guys could have had conversations about growing together, or just growing your business. So, like, you guys talk about more than just fucking. Y'all talk more than just, like, you know, who fucking who online and shit. It's like y'all talk about a lot of resources, stability, like, you know, jobs, how to be plugged with certain things. Like, y'all trying to figure out, like, how to be comfortable in life is what I'm getting here. So that is going to give you that, you know, incline to let you know that this person means business. They mean business. They're serious, and they're dedicated, all right? So it's like they have a vision with you in it, Scorpio, and I feel like they're going to offer you that position and offer you that cup of love. I said position because I'm also feeling like while this is more so love based, this could be a job or something that you truly love to do. So someone could be offering you an opportunity. Maybe someone that you love could offer you an opportunity in business as well. So again, this person, they're like, I could show you better than I could tell you, Scorpio. I'm not trying to just fuck on you. I'm trying to just, like, do all that typical shit. Like, I'm not on none of that. Like, can we make money together? Can we do business together? It's how someone could be viewing you. So I feel you could meet this person through communication, either about work or you may meet them while you're looking for a job or you're like searching for something. They may provide you with that resource. Like, you could be asking around family and friends or something like that. And I feel this person is going to get back to you like, hey, I got this and that going on, or you could try this if you want to, or I heard you was looking for a car, I heard you was looking for a job, I heard you was looking for a house. Like, I know so and so. So it's like you're going to be plugged with this person in some way, shape, or form. All right. So let's see what blockages of yours, Scorpio, that may be keeping this connection from happening. Wow. Queen of Swords. Queen of Swords. So Queen of Swords is really no nonsense. The Queen of Swords, you see her cup down there? You see how she got it in jail, in stone? Ice cold, like this Queen of Swords energy, with that coming through as a blockage of ours, Scorpio, it's like, you know what I'm saying? Even if you know everything, say that you literally knew everything, right? What fun is it to know it all? Like, what fun is it? Like, how can you truly enjoy yourself if you're just so sure this motherfucker ain't right, or this person is right, or this gonna be the best option for me, or I already know how that's gonna go. If you just know everything, sis, how are you going to be able to enjoy like those rando ass moments, like those quirky, like the best moments, the best fucking moments? How are you going to be able to enjoy those if you know every fucking thing? I feel that this is just saying, like, you could be creating a blockage of thinking that you have it already figured out. You already know the outcome of the situation, so you're rejecting it or refusing it. All right, so it's almost like allowing this previous life path, just the history of shit, to mold or create like what you want to do with your cup here. So there is the cup. The cup is, ain't nothing wrong with the cup. It ain't damaged, it ain't broke. Ain't shit wrong with that cup, Scorpio. You just put it in here. It's like you're trying to hide it from everybody, and the only reason you would do that is if you don't trust yourself. You know what I'm saying? So I feel with it being a blockage, spirit is like, do you trust me? Do you trust you? Can you trust anybody? Can you trust anybody? Because with you putting that shit in stone, it's almost like you don't trust nobody. Nobody can get to your cup. Nobody can have your cup. Why? What's gonna happen? Like, what's so? It really is just like you're limiting yourself by protecting yourself. And I feel that spirit is like, I got you. I already got you. Like, let it happen. Let it go. Let it go. I'm going to show you. I'm going to be there at all times to let you know what's for you and what isn't. I'm always going to be there for you. I always got you. You done learned enough. Have you not? See the book back there? And spirit right there? Have you not learned enough to know that you don't have to isolate yourself in order to be safe? All right? So I feel that spirit is just wanting you to be open. Crazy. Kicking my own ass, Scorpio. I'm kicking my own ass. But yes, like, get out there, be open. Be open and going out. People are calling you guilty. I'm guilty on all these levels here. People have been calling you strangers, Poppy. You don't know them like that. So you're like, ignore. Get your ass out there. Get your ass outside, Scorpio. Because I feel like it's really going to help you. Look at you, Five of Pentacles. Look at you. It's like, I got what you need. What you need? Somebody is like, the door right there, Scorpio. And the key. Just in case you need a little help, the key is right there in the corner, Scorp. Is there anything else I can help you with? You instead of just sitting there like, nah. I'll go in there eventually. don't know what the fuck. I could already tell what's gonna happen on the other side of that door. I'm gonna have to do this and that and this. I gotta change. With the five there, you have to change. You have to open up the door. You gotta unlock the safe to that cup right there, Scorpio. Because if you're just moving around, but you got your heart guarded like that, then are you fully embracing change? Are you fully embracing your lesson, you know, your experiences, the things that you've learned? Are you embracing that, or has it made you guarded now? It's like, okay, since I went through all of those things in my life, let me go ahead and lock up this cup and hide the fucking key. The key right there, Scorp. We see the key, sis. You know, so stop playing. And allow somebody to unlock that damn door, is what I'm getting here. It's like, simply put, let's see what great qualities. Enough of that. All right, I done whooped our ass enough. Now, let's see what great qualities we have that can bring this love in, Scorpio. What we got? What we got for that ass? What we got for them? Okay, we have the Page of Pentacles, Seven of Cups, and that Death and Rebirth. What else behind there? Hiding? And that Queen of Cups. Yeah, we do. Yes, we do. Yes, we do. All right, so it's like, open up, sis. Open up. Open up. Unlock that damn, that cup. Please free the cup. Free the cup, you know what I mean? And I'm not talking about, like, if you've been celibate or something like that. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about, like, be willing to trust yourself to get out there. Trust yourself to move around, meet people. Go out, like, accept the call, accept the text, accept the date. You know what I'm saying? It's like, I feel that they've been thrown to you in all shapes and forms, but you too worried about what's in the cups rather than the fact that there are cups there that you could learn from, enjoy, experience, whatever. All right? So it's like, first of all, before you go sitting up trying to think so far ahead into what the cups could possibly bring, let's just take a moment to, like, grab one. Let's take a moment to start walking, start moving, start, like, you know, actually doing the work, receiving the blessing and receiving the lesson that is coming your way. You're not going to be able to be in control of everything. So it's like, if I'm able to sit and choose the, and I carefully choose these options, then I'll only choose the best cups. I'll only choose the right ones. That's not true, because we're not in control of everybody else. I don't care how much of a guru you think you are. You're not in control of anybody else, how they move, none of that. So they could be showing you something that is completely different from who they are, and you'll never freaking know. You may feel like you do because you're Scorpio. We think we know every fucking thing, right? But this is just to say, like, hey, give it a break. See the beauty in not knowing. I know that we are so intrigued. That's like what we're born to do, is like to detect and, like, you know, research and shit. We just want to know. And I feel like this is just saying, like, there's beauty in not knowing too. I know we're so curious and we like to figure shit out, but there's beauty in not knowing. There's beauty in going with the flow. There's beauty in faith and trust in the universe, and trusting in God, trusting in your spirit, trusting in your experiences, trusting in your ancestors, trusting in your spirit guides, because you know they're there. That's the knowledge that you want to hold dear to you. That's the knowing that you want to have, that regardless of what goes on, I'm good. Because while nobody else may understand, I understand that I'm protected on different levels here. I get it. I've learned multiple times that those seeds been planted. My ancestors are with me, so I don't have anything to worry about on no fucking 3D level. What? That ain't shit. You know what I mean? So it's like understanding that. Now that's the type of protection that you have. You don't have to try to navigate or block out things, ignore things because you feel like, you know, then it'll go away, or then I've protected myself by completely just not engaging in this. You know, you may as well not engage with humans ever again if that's the case. So this is like, hey, we can deal with people, just deal with them. You can embrace situations, just do it wholeheartedly, all right? And handle situations accordingly, but you don't have to ignore or reject the invitations that you're receiving right now just because you don't know what's within them or what's really going to happen. It's like, spirit know, all right? So you have to know that you and spirit are bonded enough to protect your ass, all right? So that's what I have for you, Scorpio. I love it. Get on out there. Get on out there. You want to anyway. So it's like, I'm not telling you nothing you don't want to do. All right? So I love y'all, and I'll see you next time.